Hello, grooming fans. So today we have this so sweet poodle. He is a little matted and we're going to shave him. He's one sweet boy, he's very well behaved. He's been here before and I'm going to shave him completely from head to tail. And let's just begin with clipping his nails. And hopefully this will be the last the last video where I'm filming with my cell phone. I ordered a GoPro camera. It is a GoPro Hero 7 Black. And I also ordered another battery for it because I want to make long videos. And I can't wait for it to get to me, and the video quality will be much better, the angle will be wider, and the sound will be better. And I just can't wait. So his nails are long, they're not like too long like in some cases, but they are long. And you just have to clip the dog's nails. I don't care if the dog doesn't like it, you have to do it. And when you're clipping the dog's nails, you should always check if there's a fifth nail on the back feet. In this case it is. Sometimes the dog even has six nails, I mean six toes. But I think, yeah, that's the case. You can see this little nail. I am hoping that you can see. And that's why I have this little clipper. Okay, and the last one. You can see how big this nail is. Okay, now I'm going to take the 50 blade. This is the shortest blade, around 0.2 millimeters long, and I'm going to shave the hair between the pads. It's okay. You can see there's a lot of hair here. Hey, and last one. Okay, we're done with the pads. I am going to shave the sanitary area later because it is a little bit dirty. Now I'm going to clean his ears. You can see he has a lot of hair in his ears. And I'm going to take my hemostats out of the ethanol. Let's leave them there. And get this ear powder. It's okay. And get this out. You have to pull the hair from the dog's ears because when there's no hair in the ear, the air can flow in and out, and and if the air can go in the ear, it is less chance that the ear gets infected. Second one, okay. And he's such a good boy. He's one of those dogs that can wait to go to the groomers. And when he comes in, he's wagging his tail. He wants to cuddle. He wants to play. Let's take the hemostats, dry them a little bit. Okay. Let's take this cotton wool thing, split it in two, and clean his ears a little bit. And the next one. Okay, now I'm going to take the clipper and I'm going to use the 8.5 blade. And I'm going to start with the head. You have to be really, really careful around the lips. Super careful. Let's check if the blade is too warm. It's not. Yeah. I'm going to take the temp blade for this part of the ear. And second one, it's okay. Sorry. And okay. I'm just going to take the 8.5 blade again. You can probably see what I'm going to do and why I shave the hair first. But if you don't, it will be clear to you in a few minutes. And yeah, this is fine. And the reason why I shaved the hair, the head, okay, and the neck first, is that I want to make a good thumbnail. It is a little funny, but YouTubers need good thumbnails to get them more views. And it's the same for the dog. He is going to be shaved anyway, and just going to grab my cell phone and take a picture of him. Feel like that. Okay, we're done with taking a thumbnail picture, and I'm going to continue with shaving him. and I have to be super careful around this fifth toe. Okay, the blade just got a little warm. Just going to let it cool down and take the other blade. Okay. And you can see his private area is dirty, that's why I want to shave it after the bath. Okay, I just took the template to work around this 5th and 6th toenail because it's much safer. Those toenails often have this gingy skin and that's why I do not want to use 8.5 or 7 blade because I don't want this skin to get in the blade and injured. That's why I'm using the 10 blade. Is shorter, guys, the shorter the blade, the safer it is, because the distance between blades is smaller, it is less chance that the skin gets in these blades. And okay, it's done, I'm going to take 8.5. He is afraid of heights. Okay. Okay. And I said in my last videos, dogs usually do not like clipper to run over their front legs or their arms, as my girlfriend would say. And a lot of dogs will pull and try to avoid it, but it has to be done. And that's why when I'm shaving the front legs, I try to be as gentle as I can, even though it sometimes does not look like that, but I'm trying my best not to press too hard on the skin, but as gentle as I can. You can see how he pulls. Maybe it tickles him, makes an unpleasant feeling for him, definitely. It does not hurt him, of course. I'm just clipping his hair. And even though he's now scared and nervous a little bit, you can see after the groom I'm going to feel him, and he's going to be super happy, wagging his tail, begging for a cuddle, and... But as I said, playtime is playtime, and work time is work time. And I can pet him a little bit between the shave, between the work, but he knows he's going to have playtime after. And dogs need to know that. I said it before, playtime is playtime, work time is work time. There are dogs and that if you're working with them and start cuddling them, they're going to start wagging their tail, move their butt, coming towards you to cuddle, and even if that is sweet, that is cute, but your dog needs to be calmed down, because we are working with some extremely sharp items, and the dog needs to be calmed down. A lot of you are commenting like, you did not cuddle with the dog, you did not pet the dog, you didn't do this, you didn't do that, and that's not reality. I mean, the dog is not going to die if it does not cuddle for, I don't know, an hour and a half or 2 hours. And you could see how he was licking me. Maybe he's going to do it again. He started licking my arm, and that is also cute, but you don't want that while grooming, because he can also lick the blade, he can also lick the scissors if you're doing the scissors. So you do not want the dog licking you and kissing you while you're grooming. It may look super cute and super gentle and super sweet, but it's not the reality, and the risk of getting the dog injured is much bigger than. Sorry, someone just knocked on my door. I had to open it. And I'm going to shave the body again after the bath. This is just before the bath. Shave down. And it's fine. I have some hair sticking out, but as I said, I'm going to shave him again after the bath. I'm not going to film the bath because then the video will be too long, maybe boring, and I'll see you soon. Okay, we're done with bathing him, we're done with drying him, and it's okay. I'm going to shave him again. You can see all the hair, it's uneven. You just have to do it again. And I'm going to start with doing his private area. It's now clean. And I'm going to take the template. Okay. I'm hoping that you can see, but I'm not sure. You have to be careful around this area, because the hair is, the skin is glinty. So we shave their private area because we do not want the urine, the poop to stick this here, and that's why we're shaving it. And that's it. Now I'm going to take the scissors and trim around the feet. You have to be careful for this toe, for this nail. Lately I'm going to trim this nail a little bit more. And he is pulling, I do not know if you can see, but he is pulling little by little, and I have to be super careful because I don't want to cut his skin. And front legs. Again, I just ordered a GoPro camera. It's a Hero 7 Black, and I'm happy about it. And I'm almost done with collecting watch hours for the monetization apply. I'm now at about 3,600 watch hours, and I have around 3,000 subscribers, so I will be able to monetize my channel. I think that I'm going to collect the rest of the watch hours I need in about a week, and I think that then you wait about a month for the approval, and then I'll make money out of YouTube. And can't wait. It's okay. And I know that some groomers will do the same work much faster than me, but I am a bit slower, I have to admit it, but I always try to do the best work I can, and of course you can always skip ahead if you don't want to watch some parts, they are boring. Shh. okay. It's okay. I'm using my slicker brush to get this hair between the fingers out. You can see how much hair it is, and to now I'm going to take the tan blade and work around these risky areas, as I like to call them. It's okay. And under the armpit. Again, 10 blade is shorter than 8.5 blade. The bigger the number, the shorter the blade is, and the shorter the blade is, it is safer to use them. And these, as I said, risky area, as I call them, like behind, like the armpit, the around the fifth toenail, and some areas like that where the skin is glinty, I like to use the tan blade. Okay. Second one, okay. And okay, this area, you can see this skin is so glinty. And even if I am using the shorter blade, I am being super careful. Okay. Okay, now I'm going to take the 7 blade, it's okay. Okay, and work this leg. I think that he has some problems, health problems with that leg, so I'm going to be as gentle as I can. Okay. No. And the tail. I'm going to take the shorter blade. I mean the eight. Okay. Okay. care. We are done with his back legs. Let's do the body now. And the other side. Okay, I'm switching to 8.5 blade. Thank you. And we are done with the legs, with the body and the tail. I'm going to work with the head. I'm going to take the tan blade and do the inside. This side of the ear. And take my scissors. I'm covering the end of the ear with my fingers so I will not cut the skin. teeth, and I'm going to go around the eyes with stem blade. And tape 8.5 and do the rest. Going to the eyelashes, very, very careful. It's okay. Nah. See, when you're working around the muzzle, you have to keep the mouth closed. Pen blade again. And we are done. Okay, and we are done. You can see he is all nice and clean. And let's just see how he would react when I put him down. Can see he's one happy dog. Not afraid anymore, not scared. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I see you soon.